a new day. Pull your bridges up and tie your shoelace. Don't worry about them haters. Send them bouquets. Get that dough in a few ways.
Hey everybody, this is Alvin Brown, CEO and founder of the Center for Healing and Peak Performance. And I'm an integrated peak performance consultant and advisor. And what I do in that role and what I've been doing for the last 22 years, I've been helping my clients to achieve optimal health, peak performance, and to relentlessly pursue what brings them most joy in life. And that's what I want to do with this community. And it's been my absolute pleasure to help a lot of my clients go on to become NHL hockey players. They've gone on to become strong fitness brand in the industry. They've gone on to become orthopedic surgeons and doctors and lawyers. And also, on the flip side, I've also helped them to have great relationships, mental balance, overall health, and general just passion for life. And that's what I want to do with this community. I'm also the author of Journey to Personal Greatness, Mind, Body, and Soul. It's a blueprint for life balance and self-mastery. It's available at all your major bookstores, Barnes & Noble, Books & Mill, and Amazon, and in Canada, Chapters Indigo Online. All right, in case you're first time joining me, this is how we flow in this community here. I give you three videos a week, Mind, Body, and Soul. Monday mindset. It's a little checkup from the neck up, give you a little tip, a strategy, something to help change the game for you. Wednesday, Hump Day Hustle, it's about the body, structure, function, nutrition. How do you get the body running right? You can have a great checkup from the neck up, but if the body is not feeling it, you don't feel like driving as hard as you can. Saturday, Soulful Saturday, it's about the soul, nourishing the soul, feeling abundant, remaining authentic to who you are, and cherishing and nurturing the relationships, your ecology, the people around you. Because once you get to that finish line, I want you to feel like you deserve it, two, to remain authentic to who you are, and three, to look around and you realize that everybody that you started with, they're still with you, and you still got the friends. All right, so that's what we're talking about. All right, so this is Hump Day Hustle. This is the part of the week where we focus on the body. All right, so this week I want to talk about a topic that I've been trying to express to my clients coming in. They're always asking me, why does this problem keep coming back? Or why did I get this? Or why did I get that? And what I'm explaining to them is the body, take away all the emotional things you think about the body. You know, how it looks, how it feels, all the emotional connection to the body. And let's look at the body as a machine. Objectively, here's what the body is for: survival and procreation. That's what the body's for. It's here to survive and extend the species. When you look at the body, there's so many things built into the body to adapt. Over the millennials, we've learned to adapt to all kinds. They've even talked about adaptation in our color. When you look at somebody in Africa, when you look at Africans and people in the sunny climates, the darker skin, the melanin, enables us to stay in that sunshine and not develop skin cancer and push off these UV rays coming in, because the melanin helps to bounce it off. Now, think about this. When you go to a country, the Europeans, when they move and migrated to the colder countries with the shorter hours of the day and the colder temperatures, less sun, you need to lighten up that pigment so the sun can get in, so you can get maximum vitamin D. When you're in Africa and under the blazing sun, you don't need as much exposure, so you get that melanin. When you look at the hair, okay, the hair bounces the sun off. When we have the more curly hair, when you have the more longer and looser hair, it helps to bring it down the nape of the neck, protect you from the cold. You grow the beard. You know, so much adaptation. The nose, okay? When you have a slender nose, the wind coming in, okay? It helps to prevent that. The wider nose helps more to come in to cool the brain down. I mean, think about that. You know, those are just theories, okay? But they make sense to me. When you think about adaptation as we go throughout the years, if you go back and look at the past, they were shorter. Everyone's bigger now. The kids are bigger today. Their feet, I used to walk in a store and it was rare to see size 12. Now it's not rare to see 15s sitting on a table. So we're constantly evolving. When you look at the brain, we only had the lower brain, the primitive brain that enabled us to survive. Now we have these neocortices built on top, 6 or 7 layers now. And now we have prefrontal cortex, and the newest part of the brain to help bring consciousness. I could go on and on about the adaptations that the body does. So here's my point. Let me round it up. Here's the point. When you come in with a chronic problem in your body, Remember that you're building patterns and adaptations. When you change jobs or when you do something different, if you're an athlete and you kept doing repetitive hockey players, let's take hockey players. I get a lot of hockey players coming with lower back pain. Well, when you're taking that slap shot constantly, taking a slap shot, you're turning the same way and it's your power way. So you build up strong erectors and it adapted to that activity. When you like to sit a certain way, when you like to do a certain thing, when you look at the human body after 30, 40, 20 years, you see a lot of adaptations and you can tell what they do. You can tell what they like to do by just looking at how they adapt. So here's my point. I'm going to round it up now and tell you what I'm getting at. When you're struggling with a problem in your body that's chronic, I want you to stop and really think about what you're doing every single day. It might be, it's a thing that you love, the way you like to sit, your favorite way you like to lie, on that left shoulder, right shoulder, the way you like to cross your legs. I want you to really, your workstation is huge, 8 hours a day in the same workstation, the way you slump, I want you to start to look at your body and I want you to think about it. If I have a chronic problem that's always bothering me, I keep getting the same thing adjusted, same thing fixed, put the onus back on yourself and start looking at what am I doing that the body is adapting to. How is the body adapting from a previous injury? You could have a broken a foot and you've learned to walk a certain way. So we got to look at your gait pattern and how you've changed and adapted to that certain gait. So think about that. Think about the body objectively. And I want you to think about if you're working out, so my people are working out, boxers and so on. It goes on and on. Any sport, if you're doing it repetitively, you're building up a pattern. And I want you to start to investigate that to get rid of the chronic problem. I want you to really step back and look at what am I doing every day? And it even goes in the way of food too, by the way. Your body adapts to certain foods and you can build sensitivities to it. It goes on and on. The body, it doesn't care, all that emotional stuff. It just knows input, adapt. Input, adapt, because I got to survive. And that's what it does. So, what do you want to take away from this? Chronic problems, step back and look at what you're doing every day that might be causing a problem. Don't leave the onus on your therapist to do the only thing to fix. That's external. They see you for an hour, half an hour, 50 minutes, whatever their session is, and you have 24 hours, 24 and a half, 23 and a half hours, 22 hours to go and unwind it again. There's 168 hours in a week. You see somebody once a week, you have 167 to go and go back into your pattern. You get what I'm saying? So check that out. Think about how you can play a part. Think about how you can adapt and change. What therapist do you need to see to help you get there and get rid of that chronic problem? And that will totally help you. All right? So check out our website, the Center for Healing and Performance.com, JourneyPersonalGreatness.com. If we can help you to find somebody or if you're in our area, come in and see us to do a full evaluation on you. Because we want you to be fully healthy and achieve optimal health at the end of the day. And we do that by looking at your structure and your function, because the two are linked. If your structure is off, your function won't be right, and you won't have the proper peak performance out of your body. All right? So until next time, check out you be a part of your solution and build your fitness and health team. Right? Because I want you to be relentless about your pursuit for what brings you joy, and we call it personal greatness. Until Saturday, peace and love.
Your bridges up and tie your shoelace. Don't worry about them haters. Send them bouquets. Get that dough in a few ways. Pack your tears up inside your suitcase.